Hello there, fellow Teenlings of the Teenling Army. I'm the gaming Teenling Hearthstone, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts Ballad of Memories. Well, last episode, we pretty much started up on this, and now we're getting... Now, let us go to the next one. And, of course, I'm going to put everything pretty well on Beginner, since I pretty well, for the most part, have all the stars I need, at least for the base game, base part of it. And I already got enough of the missing sun for said area. Now it's just a matter of doing the actual... level. That's the word. Doesn't mean I'm not going to at least try with the levels here.
Take this!
It seems fitting to have Mickey Mouse here.
Thank you. Thunder!
Well, almost everything.
Come on.
Not bad. Almost actually got a full perfect act on that. But I did get a few goods. Yeah. Almost full.
Master Xehanort's plan was revealed at last. Terra, Aqua, and Ventus entered into a grueling final battle. As they fought, Xehanort summoned Kingdom Hearts. Terra's body became a vessel for Xehanort, but his lingering will and devotion to Aqua and Ventus remained attached to his armor. Even knowing that his own heart would be destroyed in the process, Ventus fought to stop the Keyblade from forming. As Ventus struggled, Aqua confronted Vanitas, who had taken control of Ventus's body. Drawing strength from her friends, she destroyed the Keyblade. Ventus's heart fell into a deep sleep. Aqua faced off against Terra, whose body was controlled by Master Xehanort. To restore his heart to him, Aqua fought with all she had. Xehanort drove Terra's heart out of his body. Terra fell to darkness. Refusing to lose her friend, Aqua sent him back to the Realm of Light. But he awoke with no memories and called himself Xehanort. Trapped in the realm of darkness and all alone, Aqua was about to give up the endless battle with darkness when her connections to her friends appeared in the form of a brilliant light and saved her. Sora, still just a child, had previously joined his heart with Ventus's. The connection they shared brought Ventus's wounded heart back to him.
because we did that, this is now opened up. And so is that. This is optional. You don't have to do this, but there are three extra songs here. Those are optional songs, but I'm not going to show them off. Unless I do get like 280 of these, I'm not going to necessarily show it off. I'm mostly just doing the main story.
As Aqua wandered alone through the realm of darkness, familiar worlds from the realm of light appeared. Something was wrong. As she hurried onward, silent visions of Terra and Ventus emerged before her. And she was even forced to fight against a vision of herself. Aqua began to realize the vulnerability of her own heart, and desperately chased after her friend's images. After defeating a massive Heartless, Aqua was finally able to speak with Terra, who had ties to the realm of darkness. But moments later, he was taken over by Master Xehanort. Aqua was saved just in time by Mickey. He was there searching for the Keyblade that belonged to the realm of darkness. Together, they arrived at Destiny Islands, which had fallen into darkness. Aqua realized that she had been to this world before, and mentioned that this was where she had met Sora and Riku, which helped Mickey find the Keyblade he was searching for. They had everything they needed. Now they just had to close the door. Suddenly, Heartless appeared, and Aqua faced them, knowing she'd be trapped in the Dark Realm. Having fulfilled her duty as a Keyblade Master, Aqua watched the world regain its light before her eyes as she fell to the depths of darkness. Years passed, and preparations were made to search for Aqua. We all set off toward different destinations, each with our hearts as our guiding key.
I will at least attempt to try to get to one of the stars. I will attempt to get that. No guarantees, though. Ground enemies, clear this. Okay, so this one's fairly simple.
Thank you.
Master Yen Sid knew that Sora and Riku still had a lot to learn before they could stop Master Xehanort, so he prompted them to take the Mark of Mastery exam. The exam required the two to dive into sleeping worlds and reawaken them by unlocking their keyholes. But an unfortunate encounter caused Sora and Riku to be flung into different worlds. Fighting alongside benevolent dream eaters, or spirits, they carried on. Suddenly, a boy in a black coat appeared.
Thank you.
going to call the episode here. Next episode, well, we'll get more of Dream About Distance songs done here. And maybe get started on Kingdom Hearts 3 here. Too soon to tell. Until then, subscribe if you want to check out other videos I've done in the past, or stay tuned for future videos on the channel. Comment down below if you think of this game, or if you have another game you want me to check out on the channel, you still let me know down below. Until next time, stay trying to stay cooler, and I'll see you.